Hello. It's getting hot. Today we have a Mazda 3, 2012, I believe. We're going to be doing the lower control arm. Already got it mostly out. Hold on. I gotta be careful not to show any of our secrets here. So the control arm comes with the bushings. So it's gonna be two bolts, another bolt here, and this bad boy. The two that go on there are 17s. The through bolt, which I don't know if you can be able to see it, goes, yeah, there's no light. But anyways, the bolt that goes to the ball joint is there. It's a 14. I believe that was a 19. It's getting stuck on the trans right now. I'm gonna use a punch to punch this bolt out. And, sometimes those are a bitch. Probably need a pickle fork to get that off. It's like that Subaru style. Sorry, there's zero light here. I don't have any set up because I don't really need it. But I'll take those out and then, yeah, go from there. Oh, there you go. Maybe you can see now here the way that ball joint works. Well, put it back in. Yeah, so for the one that went there, that was a, let's see what that was. That was a 19. What does that say? 19. I used one of those things to clear the transmission. If you watch my other videos, you know, that bushing is not going to matter. But for that bushing, you're supposed to put weight on the vehicle to torque it. Since this is very low, I'll probably just jack up the underside of the control arm so it's sitting straight when I torque that. Okay. So, to slide that back in, let's see if I can show you guys. So that's the sway bar bushing. I ended up pushing it over and the whole bracket comes off. Of course, they're not captive nuts, so I lost them somewhere in there. So I got a magnet, but now that that's on, I'll push that bushing back and get the nuts. Looks like I can access it back there, so. Okay, every fucking second of that sucked. Yeah, so basically to get those on, you're gonna need a punch, something same size as the bolt to line up basically four holes there, five actually. So yeah, it was awesome. Not a lot of room for your hands. Tighten these up and do the next side. Okay, so on the driver's side, there's this plate. It's some 12 mils. It's just a guard for your, I believe that's your AC compressor. Goes on under there. You're gonna have to take that off to get access. You're gonna wanna be careful with this line here. It's kind of in the way, but you can move it a bit. It moves, so. Yeah. So I got everything off here. I'm gonna pull it out and then, yeah, same thing as before. Oh, the torque specs are like I'll put them in the description, but I believe the horizontal bolt is 120 to 140. I believe these are 120, 89 to 120. That captive one there is 44, but I don't really need to torque that.